Tyndall effect. Objective: to learn the concept of Tyndall effect. The Tyndall effect, named after physicist John Tyndall, involves the scattering of light by finely suspended particles in something such as in colloid. This effect is also referred to as Tyndall scattering. Let's demonstrate the Tyndall effect. We'll begin by filling all three beakers with the distilled water. In the first, we'll leave just the water. In the second, we'll dissolve a spoonful of sugar. And in the other, we'll stir a few drops of milk. First, we'll shine through the beaker containing only the water. Although we cannot see the light beam as it is passing through the water, we'll be able to see it as it emerges unchanged from the other side. Now we'll shine our laser through the second beaker containing the sugar solution. Once again, we cannot see the beam as it passes through the solution, but we are able to see it as it emerges from the other side, again unchanged. Finally, we'll shine our laser through the third beaker, which has milky water. In this case, we are able to clearly see the light beam as it passes through the liquid. This appearance of a light beam passing through a liquid is the result of Tyndall effect. What is happening to the light beam? Let's take a closer look at what's in each beaker so that we'll have a better understanding. In distilled water, any particles are too small to obstruct the path of light as it passes through, meaning we won't be able to see the beam. A solution, such as a sugar solution we made, is a homogeneous mixture made up of only one phase. In this form, the solute, in this case the sugar, will dissolve in the solvent, in this case the water, and take on the characteristics of the solvent, meaning once again we won't be able to see the light hitting anything. A colloid, however, has two phases: the dispersed phase, which is the milk particles, and the dispersion medium, which is the water. In the colloid, light will scatter in different directions due to the dispersed particles. But in water and in true solutions, such as a sugar solution, it will pass through without being scattered. The Tyndall effect is used in identifying whether a liquid is a solution or a colloid. Summary: the Tyndall effect involves the scattering of light as it passes through a colloid. True solutions do not exhibit the Tyndall effect.